These are the most important settings that you need to get it right, because they have a big impact on how your colors will look like in the end. Hello scientists, welcome to Robot Math. In today's video, I will tell you about the most important setting that you need to know before starting your scientific illustrations. That is the RGB and the CMYK color coding models. If this is the first time on my channel, welcome. I'm Scientific Illustrator John, and I'm making these graphic abstract tutorials on this channel so the scientists like you can make these professional scientific illustrations for your research publications. If you find my videos helpful, please like, subscribe, and share. That can really help me to grow the channel and also help more scientists around the world. Before you start to draw any scientific illustrations, you have to get your RGB and CMYK settings right, because they have a big impact on how your colors will look like in the end. The main difference between the RGB and the CMYK is that RGB is for displaying on monitors and devices, and for CMYK it is for printing. The reason that you have to get the color modes right is that what you see on the monitors is not necessarily what you will have after you print it out. And there is actually a scientific reason behind this. So RGB is an additive color model. That means the more colors that you add on it, the brighter the color would be. And CMYK is a subtractive color model. That means that the more color you add on to the CMYK color mode, and the darker the color will be. This is a direct reflection on how these colors are technically generated on their media. So for RGB, it is monitors, and usually they have a light source that is directly the output of these colors. And so for RGB, that stands for red, green, and blue. On the monitors, you would have the light source of the red light, green light, and the blue light that is flashing out these colors through your monitors. So that's why the more colors in the RGB model that you're adding into your illustrations, the brighter your colors will become. So this is directly related to our photoreceptors in our retina, that we have these three types of the cone cells in our retina that recognize these three specific wavelengths. And the RGB model is directly stimulating our photoreceptors through the three colors that our retinas identifies. So this is a very interesting scientific and technical aspect of the RGB model and how it reflects on our result in our illustrations. So if you know that your publication is going to be digitally published, and then you will need to choose RGB. So when do you use the CMYK mode? So CMYK is when you're designing posters that you know that it's going to be printed out on papers, and then you have to choose CMYK mode. It is very important that you choose it right, because you want what you see on the screen will be what you will get on your prints. That can only be done through CMYK mode, because CMYK is a subtractive color model. That means it works as how the inks works on the prints. So the inks on the prints, they work in a reversed way of how the direct light source works. So there's a very interesting scientific mechanism behind using these four colors in this color mold, is that each color subtract the colors that we don't want to reflect. For cyan, it takes away the red, so we get to see the green and the blue. And for magenta, it takes away the green, so we get to see the red and the blue. And for yellow, it takes away the blue, so we get to see green and red. So K is black and is a combination of all three colors. And this is a technical solution for saving ink, because if you think about it, if you need to create a darker color, and every time you need to add on like all three colors, and not only will that make the ink wasting faster, but also the spot will be wetter. That might create a problem of distorting the paper surface. The people who developed this printing technique, they find the solution that let's just use black color when we want to make things darker. So now you learn the science behind these two color modes. So now you can choose wisely about which color mode that you're going to use in your illustrations. So if you know that your publication will be digital only, then you need to choose the RGB color mode. And if you know that it is going to be printed out, or if you're designing a poster, then you have to choose the CMYK mode. So check your journal guideline about which color mode that they want you to draw your illustrations in. So let's come take a look at the nature guideline. So this is the guide to preparing final artwork for nature publications, and they have a section about colors. So you see that here they specifically recommend supplying your artwork in the RGB color spectrum. And they give you the reason of why they recommend you to do that. That is because RGB provides a wider gamut than the CMYK mode when it is displaying digitally. Let's go through the four guidelines that they have over here. The second one is your artwork will be automatically converted to CMYK to be printed in a journal, but for online PDF will retain the RGB color space. What they mean is that when they're printing your artwork out, and even though you provided them with RGB, the illustration will be converted into CMYK to be printed. Because that's the only way that these images can be printed out on the paper. So it has to be converted to CMYK. They give it an example of how the conversion will affect the illustrations or the photographs. As you can see here that in RGB, the color is very vibrant, but when you convert it to CMYK, then it will become duller. It is the most common situation when you're doing these color conversion. So that is because RGB is a direct light source, and then CMYK is a reflective model. So if it's a reflective model, and then a lot of these photonic energies will be dispersed during the reflection process. So scientifically, it is very reasonable that the CMYK colors will look duller than RGB. That is a necessary distortion when we're printing things out. That comes to the third guideline, which is you can supply your artwork in CMYK instead if you wish to ensure the printed figures are replicated faithfully. So that means if you want your printed photo will look exactly as how you provided them, then you have to use CMYK. So now you might think that this third guideline contradicts with the first guideline, which recommends us to use RGB figures. It actually doesn't contradict, because like more than 90% of the journal articles are published digitally these days. So it's very reasonable that they suggest you to use RGB color mode. And also it looks much better on the monitors. So that's why they recommend you in the first guideline to use RGB. Very rarely that any of these articles are printed these days. Usually we just pass the PDF around. So it's better to use RGB as they recommend it in the first guideline. So the last guideline, the example below shows the shift in colors between RGB and the equivalent color shown in CMYK substitute details. We have already covered that the CMYK color mode will not be as vibrant as the RGB, and that is something that you have to keep in mind. In the future videos, I will show you how to set up the color settings correctly in the three software applications that we use on Drupal Med. So the three softwares are Adobe Illustrator and Inkscape and PowerPoint. I hope this video is helpful for your research. And if you like the video, please subscribe, like, and also share it with your colleagues and friends. And that can really help me to grow the channel and also help the scientists around the world. Also, leave in the comments that what you need to learn about scientific illustrations that can help your research. They're really good inspirations for me. And if you need emergency help, please visit the Zhoubaomed Patreon. There are helplines for you that give you some good advice for scientific illustrations. So I wish you all happy Zhoubaomed, and I look forward to seeing you in the future videos.